This procedure is an enhancement to my previous repair of HPFP. As you can see, all the parts has been removed. If you want to see how to remove the parts, you can check my previous videos. So you have to clean everything, set up ready to install before starting this. So the bearing and everything should be clean and oiled properly. So if you have any confusion, go for my old videos. I hope you all know the parts. So everything has to be kept completely cleaned, dust free. And these are the new o-rings that I bought. It's a high temperature o-ring for the compressor springs. And this one is a oil seal that I have used previously. So the difference is the o-ring. This one is high temperature o-ring. Previously we were using X-rings. I found the X-rings were leaking a little bit, so I thought to try this one. Make sure the o-rings are tight enough. Don't go for the regular o-ring, it should be special o-ring. It's of high quality. So once you install it, you're gonna start the complete installation procedure. You know, the spring has to come in the center so that it lifts the compressor springs. So position the springs properly at the center. Once you have that, just go for the compressor springs, and the o-ring has to be lubricated properly before installation. Once you lubricate it, just push it in, make sure it's tight enough. So install all three. And then put oil in it. This time I have used 5W40 oil. Last time I had used 0W20. So this should be fine. Once you fill oil, make sure it's free from air and just install the what do you call this, so this one has to be tight enough. I have to use my special tool in order to tighten it properly. You have to hammer it to get the full tighten. So tighten it properly. It has to be the same level of the surface. So just continue the process till you finish the tightening. See, level to the surface. Now we have installed all three. Now it's time to take the side out. For that, just fill oil in the diaphragm part. This is just to show you where the diaphragm is, where the hole is for the diaphragm. That one is the hole for the diaphragm. Now mark, after putting the top part, mark this particular side so that you know which hole goes where. Otherwise you'll find it difficult when you dip the whole unit to oil. So keep a piece of wood or something to level it properly. As you can see, the solenoid has been removed, the electrical solenoid, because we're gonna dip it completely in oil. The high pressure fuel pump has to be cleaned properly before doing this procedure, because as you can see, we are dipping completely in oil, so if it has residues, it will come out. So time to install the springs for the pistons. As I told you, you have to go through my previous video to make sure everything is in proper. Once you dip the unit in oil, you have to make sure the diaphragm doesn't hold any air in it. So I have just used a Allen key, small one, which has a soft, not soft, which doesn't have a sharp edge, and push it down till the air gets out completely. So there shouldn't be any air to escape. Once you do that, you can go ahead and install the pistons with its cap. When you install the pistons, also make sure there is no air left in it. So just press it and make sure there is no air. You have to fill a little bit more oil, then only it will be free from air, otherwise the air will get trapped in the pistons. So make sure all the three pistons are also air free, and make sure the cap is in its position. I have used a small bottle, it's a juice bottle of 1.5 liter, something like that. It's a little bit flexible, so you'll be you won't have any problem in inserting the high pressure fuel pump inside. So install all three. Just press it, make sure there is no air trapped in it. Now make sure this particular the bearing has to is in position. You don't have to have a bolt like this. This is just for my convenience. I used a bolt of 13 millimeter to hold it properly in place, because I'm gonna install it on top. So you see the marking. The marking side has to come into position so that we can install the Torx 25 screws. Just insert it. You might have noted that I did not remove the seal of this high pressure fuel pump, or the o-ring, between the top and bottom part. And we did not install the oil seal yet. This is another point to be noted. So these are the Torx 25 screws. This is the only difficult part you might find to finish with, because you need somebody to help you to tighten the Torx 25 screws. So someone has to press compress from the top and then tighten the screws after making it into its position. As you can understand that the top part will not stay in position because of the pendulum inside. You have to keep it compressed so that it stays to its position. So press it completely while installing and install all three Torx 25 screws. And there shouldn't be any gap between the top and bottom part, so make sure there is no gap in between, because as I have mentioned earlier, I don't know the Torx value. There is no technical data to repair this particular high pressure fuel pump, so we have to sort it in our own ways. So tighten all three screws properly. Make sure you don't over tighten it so that you break the threads. Once you do that, you are almost done. Take the high pressure fuel pump out and it's time to install the oil seal. Note that we did not install the solenoid yet. I did not install the bench vise on the bench because I don't have any space in my apartment. That's the reason we are holding it on our hands. So it's time to install the oil seal. Before that, you have to make suction on the diaphragm part and lock the suction syringe. That one also I have shown in my previous video.
The suction should be 53 mm in the syringe.
I was not able to record it because the syringe has lost its marking. So it's around 40 ml, I guess. The diaphragm diameter and the syringe diameter is almost similar, so you can go ahead and buy a syringe of that size. Now it's time to install the oil seal. Make sure the oil seal doesn't get torn out while you install it, because there is no particular installation sleeve for this seal. I have used a 14 millimeter box spanner to press it down. Make sure you don't beat it so hard that the oil seal completely goes in. Just gently hammer it down. Make sure it doesn't go completely in. It should reach only to the groove. You can see a sliding groove over there, so it should stop in there. Make sure all the sides are even and the groove, the sliding groove, has been reached. Now it's time to install the shaft. And when you install the shaft, you can see there is no space, so you have to put a flat head and pull it upwards. Just make sure it's evenly spaced. And it's time to measure the diaphragm. The first one is 17 millimeter and the second one is 20 millimeter. So it should be in between 17 and 19 millimeter actually. So you can see it's 17 millimeter as its acceptable range. Make sure it is not less than 17 millimeter because the oil seal might come out. Now it's time to install the solenoid, which one is the control valve for the fuel. And as this one is an easy procedure, you see the groove should be inside, and this is the way to install it. You can use H4 hex 4-bit to install it. No need to over tighten it. When you tighten it, just make sure there is no space in between. Once you have done that, you're good to go, and it's time to install it on the car. So good luck. Bye-bye.